with Pravin. In today's lecture, we are going to solve the remaining problems in the exercise 5. Okay? Problem number 26. Till now in this exercise, we have learned to find prime factors as well as divisibility tests. So these problems are based on the divisibility test and prime factors. Okay? So see the problem number 26. What is twice the product? What is twice the product of the least prime number, the least prime number, and the least two-digit odd composite number? The least two-digit odd composite number. All the concepts which are included here we have learned. We know, see here, twice means double. Double of the product. First we will find product. Product of the least prime number and the least two digit odd composite number. Okay, two numbers are there. The least prime number and another number is the least two digit odd composite number. So here they have not given direct numbers directly, they have not given. They have given statement, and using that statement we have to find those two numbers. We have to find their product. Product means what? Multiplication. So we have to do their multiplication, and at the end we have to double that product twice. So double that product. Okay. So we will go step by step. Now see, first we need to find those two numbers. The least prime number. Which is the least prime number? Least means smallest. Which is the least prime number, that is smallest prime number, that is first prime number 2, correct? So 2, we got first number 2. Okay, then second, the least 2 digit odd composite number. It's quite lengthy, see, the least 2 digit odd composite number. See, how many conditions are there? Then we have to find such numbers in which, see, the least, it should be least, it should be two digit, it should be odd, it should be composite. Such number we have to find. Now you know that composite numbers means what? The numbers which are not prime. We know prime numbers and the remaining numbers are composite. Composite numbers means basically which have more than two factors. Okay? So composite numbers, it should be composite, it should be odd. Odd means what? The numbers which have 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, these digits in the ones place at the end. Okay? Odd means odd is the opposite of even. Odd numbers means the numbers which do not come in the table of 2. Then it should be 2 digit and it should be least. Smallest 2 digit. So if you talk about smallest 2 digit composite number, smallest 2 digit composite number, it is 10, correct? 10 is the smallest 2 digit composite number, because 10 is not prime, it is composite. After 10 there is 11, but 11 is prime number, correct? We have 10, 10 is the smallest 2 digit number, it is composite, but it is not odd, it is not odd, it is even, because last digit is 0. After 10 we get 11, but 11 is not composite, it is prime. Then there is 12. 12 is composite. 12 is composite but even. It is even number as last digit is 2. So it is even number. After 12 there is 13. 13 is not even, it is prime number. Then there is 14. 14 is composite. 14 is composite but it is not odd, it is even. Okay, 14 is composite number but it is not odd, it is even number. We want the least 2 digit odd composite number. As since we want least, so we are going from least towards, least, from least, okay. So we first found least 2 digit composite number, that was 10 but it was not odd, it was even, composite but even. We want composite but odd. So after 14 there is 15. 15 is, see, 15 is composite number because it is not prime. It is composite, and since there is 5 at the end, so it is odd also. So the number which we want, which we expect, which is suitable for these conditions, it is nothing but composite, odd, and it is this also according to these conditions. Okay, so the number which we want is nothing but 15. Because 15 is composite number, odd number, and it is least according to the condition. So now we have got both the numbers 2 and 15. So the product, we will find first their product. Product means multiplication, 2 into 15. That is 15 2s are 30. So we don't have to find only product, we have to find twice the product. Twice means double. Twice the product. Twice means double, and how we make double? By multiplying with 2. So 30 into 2. 32s are, double means 2s are. 32s are 60. This is the expected answer. Understood? What we have done first we found least prime number, it was 2. Then we find the least 2-digit odd composite number, it is 15. And then we found the product, and after that we double the product, find the twice of the product. Okay. See the question number 27. Which least number from 0, 1, 2, and 7 be added to the product 558 into 506 so that the resulting number would be divisible by 5. So this example is based on the divisibility test of 5. See, here two numbers are given, 558 into 506. And when we find their product, in the product, out of these four numbers, 0, 1, 2, and 7, out of these four numbers, which number should be added in the product so that the resulting number will be divisible by 5. Okay? Now for this, we must know the divisibility test of 5. What is divisibility test of 5? If the number or digit at units place is, the digit in the units place is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Then, see, what we have to do here, according to the divisibility test of 5, we want just ones place digit. We want just ones place digit, right? So, we are not going to multiply this whole number. What we are going to do, we are going to multiply only the digits at ones place. Okay, that is 8 into 6. 8 6 are 48. Okay, 8 6 are 48. So when we multiply 8 into 6, 8 6 are 48, 8 is coming in the ones place, 4 will be taken care of. Okay, so in the product, in the product of 558 into 506, we are getting the digit in the ones place is 8. So when we will find product of these two numbers, in the ones place which digit we will get? 8. Why we are finding only the digit at in the ones place? We don't need the whole product, whole multiplication we don't need. We need just the digit in the ones place. Why? Because to check or to find the answer whether the number will be divisible by 5 or not, we just want the digit in the ones place, because the divisibility of test of 5 says if the digit in the ones place is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Just by seeing the digit in the ones place, we will come to know whether the number is divisible by 5 or not. So here we want the product or the digit in the product only in the ones place. Digit of ones place. Okay. So we have found ones place digit here 8 and here 6. So 8, 6 are 48. So in that 48, 8 will come in the ones place, 4 will be taken carry. Okay. Now see, since there is 8 in the ones place, according to the biggest bit test of 5, we want 0 or 5 in the ones place. So, to get 0 or 5 in the ones place, out of this 4, 0, 1, 2 and 7, which digit should be added in the 8? To get 0 or 5? See, to get the number divisible by 5, there must be 0 or 5 in the ones place. Okay, so since there is now 8, now there is 8, okay, and we want 0 or 5. So if we add, see, 8 plus 0, if we do 8, if we add 0 in the 8, it will remain 8 only. If we need, we will add 1 in the 8, 8 plus 1, what will we get? 9. So we want 0 or 5. Then if you add 2 in the 8, what will we get? 8 plus 2, 10. That means we will get 0. 10 in the 10, there is 0, right? So we will get 0. If you add 7 in the 8, what will we get? 15. Here also see, in the 15, last digit is 5. So if we add 7 in the 8, then also the number will become divisible by 5. What we want? Least. Out of these, smallest one you have to find. So smallest one is 2. So 8 plus 2 is 10. So here we are getting 0 in the last. That means when we add 2 in the 8, the number or the product will become divisible by 5. So when 2 will be added, the product will become divisible by 5. Understood? See, once again see here, we have to add out of these 4 numbers, 0, 1, 2, 7, out of these 4, we have to add one least number in the product of these 2 numbers so that the product will become divisible by 5. And what divisibility test of 5 says? If the ones place digit is 0 or 5, the number is divisible by 5. So we need just the product, the digit in the ones place. In the product, okay? So in the ones place, when we multiply the ones place of both these numbers, we got 48. That means 8 is coming in the ones place. So there is 8 and we want 0 or 5. So out of this 4 number, which least smallest number we need to add? We need to add 2. So that 8 plus 2 we are getting 10. And in 10 there is 0 in the last, okay? So the answer is 2. That's it. Pause this video, write this in your notebook. Two more problems we will solve today. Let's solve next two problems. Problem number 28 and 29. Problem number 28 is, which two digit of number 7251 be interchanged so that resulting number would be divisible by 6. So here we have number 7251. So in this number there are 4 digits, 7, 2, 5 and 1. So out of these 4 digits, which 2 digits should interchange, replace, so that the new number will be divisible by 6. Now here we must know the divisibility test of 6, which is that, what is the divisibility test of 6? If the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, if the number is divisible by 2 as well as 3, then it will, the number is divisible by 6 also. So here if you see this number 7251, its last digit is 1, that means it is not divisible by 2. and the sum of the digits we are getting 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, 10 and 5, 15. Sum of the digit is 15 and 15 is divisible by 3. So it is divisible by 3. Means this number is divisible by 3 but not by 2. That means it is, now it is not divisible by 6. Now the number, this number, original number is not divisible by 6 because it is not divisible by 2. To become divisible by 6, it must be divisible by 2 as well as 3. So now it is divisible by 3 but not by 2. So we have to interchange the two digits so that it will become divisible by 2. So once it is becoming divisible by 2, automatically it will become divisible by 6 also. So see, the above number is divisible by 3. Now why divisible by 3? Because sum is, since sum of digits is 15. Sum of digits is 15, so it is divisible by 3. Okay? The whole number is divisible by 3, but not by 2. Why it is not divisible by 2? Because last digit is 1. And to become divisible by 2, which digit we want in the last? Either 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. So now see, to become divisible by 2, the digit at unit's place must be zero or two or four or six or eight. Okay. So what we will do to bring here which digit we can replace here? As we have to interchange any two digits. So instead of one, we will bring two, and instead of two, we will take one. So we must interchange the digits two and one, because one is now in the ones place and two is at hundreds place. So we need to bring two in the ones place and we need to take one in the hundreds place. So when two will come in the ones place, the number will become divisible by 2. And once it is getting divisible by 2, it is already divisible by 3, and once it is getting divisible by 2, it will become divisible by 6 also. Okay? So now, new number is, after interchanging digit, new number is 7, 1, 5 and 2. Okay? 7, 1, 5 and 2. And this is now divisible by 6. Understood? So which two digit we need to interchange? 2 and 1. Okay? Question number 29. Find the least 3 digit number which is divisible by both 8 and 10. Which is divisible by both 8 and 10. Now here also we need to know the divisibility test of 8 and 10. Okay. What is divisibility test of 10? It's very easy. If the last digit of the number is 0, then the number is divisible by 10. So you know, we want three digit numbers. So first we find the least 3 digit number. Smallest 3 digit number, which is that? Everyone knows that smallest 3 digit number is nothing but 100. Now see, 100 is divisible by 10 because last digit is 0. But whether it is divisible by 8, that we need to find. If you divide 100 by 8, what is divisibility test of 8? the number formed by last three digit, the number formed by last three digit is divisible by 8, then the whole number is divisible by 8. Now already there are three digits, so we need to divide it and check. So 8 ones are 8, 10 minus 8 2, bring 0 down, 8 2 are 16. So we have a remainder 4, that means 100 is not divisible by 8. So this is not the least 3 digit number which is divisible by both 8 and 10. It is only divisible by 10. Okay. Not divisible by 8. The next number which is divisible by 10 can be, we want a 0 at the end, that means after 110, next number having 0 is 110, correct? 110, next 3 digit number. Next 3 digit number which is divisible by 10. Is 110. So let's check whether 110 is divisible by 8 or not. Again, see 8 ones are 8. 11 minus 8 is 3. Bring 0 down. 8 threes are 24. 30 minus 24, 6. Here also 110 is not divisible by 8. Not divisible by 8. By 8. Okay. Let's check another number. Next 3 digit number. Which is divisible by 10. Which is that? See, the number which is divisible by 10 means it must have 0 at the end. So after 110, next 3 digit number is 120, which is divisible by 10. 120. So let's check whether 120 is divisible by 8 or not. 8 ones are 8. 12 minus 8 is 4. Became 40. 8 fives are 40. Yes. 120 is divisible by 10. Okay, so this is the least 3 digit number which is divisible by both 10 and 8. So the least 3 digit number which is divisible by 8 and 10 is which is that 120. Got it? See now 28 and 29 we have solved. The 30 question number 30 you have to solve by yourself. It is same like this. Okay. So thank you for today and have a nice day.